Zaragon here. I have assimilated more than 17,000 albums from around the world in my 35 years as a music connoisseur. To explore this journey in depth, see the Trimax Music Database on RYM and the Directory of American Bands on JazzRockSoul.com, both linked in the description below. While you're at it, hit the like and subscribe buttons and the bell and share this video. Today, we're going to examine two tracks by Steely Dan from their 1975 album, Katy Lied. And the first of those is the side two opener, Everyone's Gone to the Movies. Very angular, upbeat song by Steely Dan, although the lyrics are a little bit seedy in ways that I don't think I ever noticed before. I always assumed that it was about going out to see movies like in the old days, like during their childhood, you know, the classic Hollywood drive-in theaters, back when 3D was a novelty. And the kind of stuff that was on, that was shown on like UHF stations across the nation back by the 70s, you know, old black and whites and such. But no, I think the lyrics may actually be about some pimp luring teenagers on the brink of legality into porn, into the blue screen. I think everyone's gone to the movies is maybe just a euphemism for the blue screen, yeah. And musically, anyway, a lot of Steely Dan songs have kind of somewhat lurid double meaning to them, like embedded in, like subtly woven into certain metaphors that you gotta decode and such. But musically, the first thing that really slays me with this track, that's always made it like a standout, one of my favorites by the band, is that vibraphone riff at the beginning. And that's played by Victor Feldman, yeah, the ever ubiquitous. And of course, we go into that that really angular verse, really melodic, spiky, with that emphasis on twos. Dun, 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 dun. Dun, dun. A progression that was later appropriated by Joe Jackson in Is She Really Going Out With Him? Yeah. Dun, 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 dun. And then we go into that that chorus that, you know, based on the intro theme with the harmonies by Myrna Matthews, Shirley Matthews, and Carolyn Willis. Oh, as well as Michael McDonald, who sings background on throughout this album. And anyway, I also love how the chorus resolves on C major 7. Yeah, beautiful chord right there with and how the vibraphone hits it. And let's see, details that I've noticed these in the past. Maybe I haven't. Maybe they just kind of went by me. I cut them on a subconscious level, but here I was really noticing that kind of oozing, creeping in sax. Very subtle the first time, and then a little bit more pronounced the second time it came in. That, and you saw me enacting it. That, and and that electric piano solo, yeah, with those kind of like slightly distorted sounds. Yeah, beautiful. Love those notes. And the way they complemented that vibraphone. And then, yeah. And just the overall playout of the track. A real kind of jovial number. Yeah, take it however. It could be about the blue screen. It could be about a CD guy, a CD casting couch guy. Or it could just be about going to some old Cinemaplex to relive the old days, you know, the great black and white movies of the 1940s, 1950s, kind of like nostalgia for that era during the mid-1970s, yeah, when it was still kind of, when those were still recent decades and still, like, close to a lot of people's hearts, you know, people like Fagen and Becker's age, you know, born, you know, prime boomers and such, able to remember, dimly remember that era of Hollywood. And now on to the next track on side two of Steely Dan's 1975 release, Katy Lied, Your Gold Teeth 2. Thank you. I just love the overall jazzy feel of that track. It's kind of got like a misty quality to it, a misty, cloudy day feel and vibe, kind of autumny, wintery. Yeah, and I believe lyrically it's a follow through on Your Gold Teeth and the character, the continuing saga of the protagonist of that song from Countdown to Ecstasy. And in the first song, it was about a female grifter who gets by on her attractiveness. And let's see. Got a feeling I've been here before, watching as you cross the killing floor. You know you'll have to pay it all. You'll pay today or pay tomorrow. You fasten up your beaded gown. Then you try to tie me down. Do you work it out one by one or play in combination? You throw out your gold teeth. Do you see how they roll? I have seen your iron and your brass. Can't you see it shine behind the glass? Your fortune is your roving eye, your mouth and legs, your gift of the runaround. Torture is the main attraction. I don't need that kind of action. A torture is the main attraction, huh? Some mixed metaphors here. Your gift for the runaround. I take it to mean a woman who uses sex as a weapon. And I don't need that kind of action. You don't have to dance for me. I've seen your dance before. Do you throw out your gold teeth? Do you see how they roll? Tobacco, they grow in Peking. In the year of the locust, you'll see a sad thing. Even Kathy Barbarian knows. There's one roulette she can't sing. Dumb luck, my friend, won't suck me in this time. Got a feeling I've been here before. Won't you let me help you find the door? Oh, you got to do is use your silver shoes, a gift for the runaround. Use your knack, darling. Take one step back, darling. There ain't nothing in Chicago for a monkey woman to do. Do you throw out your gold teeth? Do you see how they roll? Okay, yeah. Yeah, about a grifter woman. I just love the little details to that song. Victor Feldman heard once again, but only faintly. The vibes just presented kind of a background glow, didn't quite take the frontal stage like they did in the other track. And we had like light piano sprinkled all about, and cymbal-laden drumming to the whole kind of 50s jazzy feel of this track, and some legato cocktail guitar. The solo on this one was played by Denny Dias, yeah, who had been a member of the actual Steely Dan band for its first three albums. All the drums on this album are played by Jeff Porcaro, yeah, the late great one. Bass guitar split between Wilton Felder, Chuck Rainey, and Hugh McCracken is the main guitarist on that. Michael Omartian, David Paich on keyboards, and Michael McDonald, of course, on background vocals, and Donald Fagen, vocal, piano, keyboard, saxophone, Walter Becker, bass guitar. The band that spent months just laboring over each passage of each song, trying to get, and doing all these dozens upon dozens upon dozens of takes, countless days and night, trying to get perfection in the studio, and only hiring the best that LA and sometimes New York could offer. Yeah, produced by Gary Katz. This album, it's hard to pick a peak from this period of theirs, because they were all just so precise, and I'm not even going to play that game. Yeah, they're all great in their own way. And the first track in the set, though, just have, if I was to pick like only three Steely Dan songs, Everyone's Gone to the Movies would be one of them, and it's primarily because of that vibraphone riff. And I wish they had made mallets that front and center in more tracks. They have a marimba solo in Asia, the title track, but there aren't many in their catalog. Yeah, that really standing out. But then again, I guess if they had used it more, that track wouldn't be so unique. So there you have it. Two of the standout deep cuts from Steely Dan's 1975 fourth album, Katy Lied. Yeah, Everyone's Gone to the Movies and Your Gold Teeth 2. For more rubies and sapphires from the catalog of Steely Dan, see the directory of albums by American singer-songwriters, pop, and blue-eyed soul artists, linked in the description below, for Red Hot Tracks and Purples from all the Steely Dan albums from 1972 to 2003, yeah, and as well as some solo work by the two members, Donald Fagen and Walter Becker. And also see the other profile I did on Steely Dan last year. Yeah, I did a couple of tracks from The Royal Scam. Green Earrings and another one. Like and subscribe, follow me on social media, share the video, and leave a comment if there are any observations you have about the two tracks we just heard. The layers, the interplay, the soloing, the composition, who had the best moment, what was your favorite instrumental input, the lyrics. Yeah, there a lot can be said about Steely Dan lyrics. And the overall impact of these tracks. And until next time, this is Zaragon, the world's most ear-traveled trimaximist, signing off.